Hello and welcome to this short demonstration of Shopify SAP Business One integration. Today we'll be showing you how you can connect your Shopify online store with your back office SAP Business One ERP system using APPSeCONNECT. So this is a demo store of Shopify that we currently have connected with the SAP Business One system through APPSeCONNECT. I'll be showing you a few of our integration processes of APPSeCONNECT. So let me first show you the customer download process. And I'll just register as a new customer from the front end of the Shopify store. So I'll just create a new address for this customer as well. So I've just saved the address of this customer. Now let me head back to the SAP server where we have the agent of APPSeCONNECT installed. This is the agent of our integration platform, APPSeCONNECT. To know more on how you can configure the APPSeCONNECT on cloud and configure the agent as well, you can watch this video, which has shown all the steps, intermediate steps and details. One important feature of our connector is that we have both the options, automatic as well as manual trigger. So as you can see, all the processes over here are set as auto. So a particular process set as auto means that this process would keep on running after a uniform period of time. And for example, if a new customer registers on the front end of your Shopify store and if the customer download process is set as auto, it would automatically get downloaded to your SAP Business One Business Partner Master Data. Alternatively, you can also set it into manual and you can click on this button to manually sync back the customer details from your Shopify store to SAP Business One. For the demonstration purpose, let me show you the automatic synchronization process. So I think the customer has already been downloaded. So let's head back to the business partner section and open the business partner master data. So as you can see, this is the customer whom just registered, Shubhajit Goswami. This is the telephone number that I fed in. This is the email address. And in the address panel, we also have the address that I just provided in the Shopify store, City Los Angeles, zip code 9005, California, USA. So now let me just show you how you can list items in your Shopify store directly from your SAP Business One. So let me just create a new item. And you can set in the price as well. And in the remarks section, you can even provide the description or short description of the item that you wish to list in your Shopify store. And I'll just save it. And we have a separate section for listing the processes that sync information from SAP to Shopify. So we have the product upload process, product add, and we have we have this particular process set as auto as well. So let's just wait for a few seconds and get uploaded to the Shopify store. I think it's uploaded. So let's open the backend of the Shopify store and let's go to the products. So as you can see, this item is already being listed. So if I open the product information page, as you can see, this is the description, the item name. This is the detail, the short description of the item that I provided in the remarks tab of the item master data in SAP Business One. This is the SKU, the price is 500. And by default, we set it an inventory of 1. So I can directly choose an image. And you can even list it in a particular category. And save it. So now let me head back to the SAP Business One and provide an initial inventory as well. So let me create a goods receipt for this item. And let the quantity be 1000. So I provided a quantity of 1000. And this as well, for the stock upload, we have the automatic process. But let me just do it in a manual sync now. So it's already uploaded. So let's head back to the Shopify store and let me show you the stock that I just updated from SAP to the Shopify store. So let's go to the products. And as you can see, it has been updated. So it's 1000 in stock now. So let me go to the front end and go to the collections. So this is the item that I just listed in the Shopify store, and I provided a initial inventory stock of 1000. So I'm still logged in as Shubhajit Goswami, and let me just add it to cart and place an order. And I'll show you then how you can directly download orders from the Shopify store to SAP Business One as well. So for the demo purpose, I'd be just doing a offline payment like cash and delivery. But in case your payment gateways are configured, we can download the payment transaction ID and other details to the payment means section of the SAP Business One. So I'll continue to the next step, and I'll just select an offline payment method, cash on delivery, and complete my purchase. So the order has been placed and the order ID is 1029. So let's head back to the SAP Business One server. And I think the order download process is set on automatic as well. So if you just wait for a few seconds, that as well would be populated as a sales order in the SAP. So I think it's downloaded, and let's check the sales order document then. If I just check the last document. So yes, this is the sales order. This is the order that I just placed in Shopify store. Shubhajit Goswami, this is the item, this is the quantity that I placed in. And for the demo purpose, we have not mapped the tax codes. So in a live implementation, in a live environment, we map the tax codes as well. So a tax which is applicable, which is applied while an order is placed in Shopify, the corresponding tax code in SAP Business One as well would be shown over here, so that the order total is exact and accurate. For the demo purpose, we don't have the fret configured as well, but the fret as well can be mapped and configured in the live process. So let me just create a delivery document for this particular sales order. And this particular order is currently in the unfulfilled status in the Shopify store. So if I go to the orders, it will show that the status is unfulfilled. So as you can see, this order placed by Shubhajit Goswami, the payment status is pending as it's an offline payment method that I selected, and the status is unfulfilled. So the delivery upload process is an automatic as well. So let us just wait, and then I'll refresh the page and we'll just see that the status has been changed to fulfilled. So let's refresh the page. Okay, so as you see, it's being fulfilled now. The delivery has been uploaded and the status has changed to fulfilled. There are some other synchronization processes as well with our connector, but this was just a short demonstration to show you the basic features of our connector. If you have more queries, if you want to know more about the features of APPSeCONNECT, please feel free to contact us.